What single in-game achievement is your go-to Mad Lad story? Mine is the time I managed to make an angel fall and switch sides in an Adeptus Evangelion game. An NPC told my character to lay on the floor, and he did it!
Absolute madman, isn't it? I absolutely love that meme. That is that's one of my
it's
favorites.
So good.
Oh, I love it. If you don't know what it is, I'll flash it up on screen for you.
Our goblin sorceress grappled a gargoyle, flew with it into the air, and then fell down, making the gargoyle take full damage before fireballing it and herself for a finisher. That was badass.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty badass.
I'll give you credit. That does sound like a proper... That sounds like a Mortal Kombat finisher.
Yeah.
That does sound pretty cool. I'll give you credit.
Party visited Lizardman tribe. Chief wants us to marry his daughter and offers a bunch of rinkets to sweeten the deal. My character, Human Rogue, has greed as a drawback, fails a will check and agrees to get hitched. We end up dragging my new wife across the wilderness. She can't fight but cooks and is quite affectionate.
Wait, did you just get a skilly wife?
Yeah, skilly waifu. She is eventually captured by a tribe of half-orcs and killed when a rescue attempt goes south.
Aww.
Aw, R.I.P. skilly waifu. Spent the next 3 campaigns hoarding gold and making connections. Between 2 campaigns, we hire a mercenary company and genocide the half-orcs of the face of the earth. Take the bones of my lizard wife and bury her in the garden of a house I bought with some leftover gold. Retire my character after that. Been 15 years since then, but that's still my favourite character.
It's awesome.
Oh, that's so cute.
There's nothing better than to be able to retire a character and be happy with that.
Would you genocide half-orcs for me?
Yes, I would genocide half-orcs.
Good.
But I do love the idea of being able to actually guitar a character and just have a nice, because let's be honest with you, adventurers don't get happy endings.
No.
You know, they,
I like this.
This is wholesome.
A happy ever after.
Yeah.
Well, kind of.
Happy ever after. But he gets his resolution. He gets to be, what's his face? Thanos in his garden. Like, yeah, he does die. But at least he got something.
I drop kicked a haunted house to death.
Beast.
The long and short of it is that our DM was running a fantastic Kingdom Hearts story. Would love to play that. Using every piece of fiction he ever heard of. Using a modified version of Dark Crusade. I played a dubstep-themed Kamen Rider.
Oh,
dubstep theme. My friends were a Digimon Tamer, a D&D hero daddy / user of Weibu Phaitan Magic, Desert Wind, and our Keyblader, Benny.
I do like having a match, mishmash, yeah. You know what I mean?
I would love to play a Kingdom Hearts game. Would love to play it. I'm obsessed with Kingdom Hearts. Fucking would love it. Leave me alone. The DM made a terrible mistake. He let his girlfriend try to run what was ostensibly a horror interlude with 4 people immune to fear. We were trapped in this world for no particular reason, with an obviously haunted house. We humoured it, going in, getting spooked and assaulted by poltergeists, and separated. Eventually, we reunited, and we had reached the end of our amusement with the spooks, so we started no-selling the various tricks and traps with our hard-earned abilities and skills, and the house started morphing to utterly negate us using them. This continued until such point as the tamer and my rider were flatly ejected from the house.
What is this, poltergeist?
Yeah.
It's poltergeist.
Frankly, at this point, we were tired of the carnival coaster tier railroading. The writing was on the wall that unless drastic action was taken, this was going to stretch onto a whole nother session of lame jump scares. So I did what my character did best. Activate his driver 3 times, spent fate, and put all my dice on the table. And so did the tamer, who mega evolved his Digimon. My rider drop kicked the house with a fist full of righteous fury, and the Digimon started nuking it. At this point, the real DM started describing the screaming and shuddering of the house as it was reduced to rubble. And we finished the session with a round of jokes about killing a house.
Yeah, not bad. Honestly, if you know where it's going, and let's be honest with you, if you've got no intention of, like, cleansing this haunted house, what else can you do but destroy it?
Dropkick it.
Yeah, like, that's the only options you got, like, you know.
My fighter took out an ancient white dragon, essentially by himself.
Not bad going, like,
yeah,
that's
not
pretty
bad
hard
going by
you.
Yourself. It tore out the rogue and the sorcerer. The cleric was too busy doing damage control, but we did manage to box it in. The sorcerer's obscuring mist carried the day, because I had the blind fight feat and the dragon did not. Orangenus favoured me that day, and I managed to power attack through 300 health in 2 rounds.
Oof.
Fuck! Ooh. In 2 rounds? Ooh. Fuck!
What level were you to do this?
Fuck. It started a running gag that my fighter only performs at his best when no one can see him doing cool shit.
It's not a weasel way,
though. Honestly, taking out fucking 300 health in 2 rounds? What the fuck are you using?
I know.
What level are you?
I know. Well, it has to be some high level.
Has to be.
But, no, I kind of do this sometimes. Like, you know, I've been really abusing a gem of brightness and essentially just using it as, like, a flashbang.
Yeah.
Like, let's be honest with you. If there's a room and we know that there's bodies in it, just flashbang them the second you open the door.
Yeah.
You know, and it's...
It means you get advantage.
Yeah,
so
exactly. Works really well, so it does.
Stole an airship from the villain faction because the DM couldn't think of a reason why it wouldn't work. An airship made of solid adamantium,
oh,
which he sold for 7 million gold.
Oh my Beast. God, that is that. I want to know where you get 7 million gold from. Mm-hmm. Although I really do think whenever he says it's made of adamantium, can I just think of it as like a gigantic zeppelin? Is it a zeppelin actually?
No.
Would you think? I think it would be.
I would more think of it being like a. You know, like the one from Marvel that's in the sky, like the airship?
Oh, yeah.
If it costs 7 million, then something like that.
Yeah, well, we don't know the setting, but like, still, 7 million gold's a lot. Like,
7 million gold?
it's 7 million gold's still 7 million gold, that's what I'm talking about, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna, ain't no one gonna turn that down, you know? You got health potions for days!
Not me, but my players. They escaped a town that was suffering a riot / civil war. By flying from the airship docks while shooting down the docking bridge the enemies were on. Before that, they split an airship in half by hitting it in just the right spot to detonate its combustible internals.
Hey,
fucking crazy escape, and I'm proud of them.
Yeah, that's good. It's always nice to hear a DM proud of his grip.
Yeah,
you know, I'm almost getting tired of hearing like horror stories and stuff, and I'm kind of just like I'm feeling like that boomer. Sort of
yeah,
feel,
where's
you know,
the good
stories? Give me the good stuff. I just want, I want the happy stuff. I want the nice stuff. I want to hear about you having fun with your mates. And, you know, I don't know, maybe it's because we've done that many horror stories. I'm like, oh, please, just walk out of the room. Just get up and leave.
Get up, leave. Say bye.
Or never just sit down and actually talk to the fucking person.
Yeah.
Like, look, mate, you're getting on like a bit of a dick. You know what I mean?
Dick with a couple of days.
Like, you are getting on like a bit of a dick. Can you dial that back a wee touch, please? I like stuff like this, and I'm happy for that DM.
Hey guys, this is just a quick bit of promo. We got our website up and running, and we have a massive restock on most of the models. However, one of the cool things about the website is if there's a model that you're waiting on, you can enter your email and be put on a waiting list. And it's not just good for you, so then you'll know when they're restocked. We can also see what you guys are waiting on and what we should be printing. So either way, the models are by far the best way to support this channel and to help us do videos that YouTube would find inappropriate on the platform. And, like, let's be serious. The models are pretty based looking, so. Once again, just look at the titties. Look at the lizard titties! But anyway, let's continue on with the video. The time my players escalated a religious war into a nuclear war. Tell it, motherfucker.
Right, oh, see, it's stuff like that. I see when I'm guys in TG and people just like, no, mate, you're going to have to explain. You need to elaborate that shit.
At least
shit.
This guy explained.
Yeah, I'll give you credit. You did deliver.
Be me. DM. Be party. Dex fighter. Cleric. Battlemaster fighter. Bard. And Eldritch Knight fighter. We're playing 5e. Shut up, I know about 5e.
Honestly, I see it all the time. I can say, ooh, stop playing 5e. It's like, look. That's easier said than done. It's really hard to find people.
I know. People who don't play 5e.
It's just like it's just difficult. Like, you know, there is plenty of other systems that I do really want to experiment with and get into, but try and find the players.
I know. You tell me where they are.
Like, you know, where are they all hiding at? They're all playing together. Or is this like, you know, the stereotype of 5e is like the cancer chamber where it just keeps everyone away? Everyone, all the ship players, like, you go play 5e and we'll, like, you know, only the good ones seep out, you know?
Party is all secret police of an expansionist Imperial power. Imperial nation is massively advantaged against all opponents due to MacGuffin-powered tech. First session. Party experiences first ever loss by their nation since the start of this crusade. Enemy forces had a proto-MacGuffin-powered reactor within the stronghold that the party was storming. Some engineer makes a go kablooey. Kablooey.
I wasn't as enthusiastic.
Kaboom!
I'm sorry, mate. Capitalize that shit. Capitalize that.
Reserve forces crush the rest of the Imperial army and take the leader of the vanguard as POW. Turns out the POW is an important dude's son. He sends the party on a secret mission to get him back. They take an airship and dress it with their own men's corpses, blood, etc. Fly straight into enemy airspace, claiming to be mutineers. Enemy nation takes the bait and escorts them in. Cleric realizes he doesn't want their MacGuffin-powered ship to be reverse engineered by this nation. Rigs up the engine room to explode with remote detonators. Party gets processed, declared as heroes to the nation for delivering an intact MacGuffin ship and given titles and estates. Party goes to get a drink and gather info. Bard goes to check out their new digs. Cleric follows some shady dudes out of the tavern. Three fighters all meet up with a group of dwarf thieves that want to break out an important ransom target from some local mafia boss. Cleric, trickery domain, follows shady dudes back to the mafia boss's house and snips around for a bit. Finds the POW and the bard, who got nabbed by the mafia dude's goons when he checked out the house. Fighters go through sewers to get to the mansion's hidden dungeon. Dwarfs eat through the wall. Mulch Diggum style.
Oh, mate, I love that. Right, if you guys don't know, that's fucking Artemis Fowl, so it is. In that setting, dwarves actually tunnel with their mouths. They actually eat it and they shit it out. I love that book. Honestly, I'm so sad about the movie. I don't want to talk about it, okay? Honestly, if you haven't got the chance, the books were great, kids. But, like, genuinely, Harry Potter sucked my balls. You know,
is that
what I mean?
The one with the Golden Compass? Is that?
No, that was His Dark Materials. Philip Pullman.
Yes.
But no, this was Owen Colfer. I actually went to go see Leiden. They were coming out whenever I was a child, and my granny took me to one of the Leidens of the author Owen Colfer, and he read like the first couple of chapters. It was actually really cool. One of those ones. I think I would have been maybe about 10 at the time. But anyway, enough about gushing. Anyway, let's keep going.
Cleric accidentally sets off a silent alarm while he's untying the bard. The two of them take out the posted guards, but then the boss and his elite goons show up. What followed was a very short, very violent encounter. Everyone pulled out guns, swords, and magic. One of the dwarves explodes from a point-blank shotgun blast. Parney manages to rip the boss and his goons apart by sheer force of action economy. Eldritch Nightfighter ends it with a firebolt straight up the boss's shotgun barrel. The man's head gets blown apart like Daffy Duck, but way more brains.
Like that guy off TikTok.
Oh, fuck off! Party grabs the POW and dips. The sound of the fight attracted the rest of the manor guards. Everyone is out of spell slots, class features, etc. No one wants to fight. Cleric does some math and makes a decision. He asks everyone for the rest of their shape charges, same ones he used earlier to sabotage the ship. He arms all of them and tells the party that it's been an honor and a privilege. Goodbye. He runs back into the dungeon and blows everything to shit. Both the manor and the sabotage ship went up. The ship went, pseudo-nuclear. 300,000 dead in an instant, and way more than that got morphed slash changed into Cronenberg-esque monsters. A quarter of the city was just gone, LMAO. Nation thought the Imperial forces had escalated to pure annihilation, so they responded with their own missile prototypes. By the time the party got back to their country, there wasn't much left of it. So now they're trying to conquer the world on their own. Pretty fun campaign so far.
I'll give them credit.
That's pretty good.
If they're having fun with it, yeah. I know not everyone be you can't do that. It's like if they're a pack of murder hobos and they're actually like they are trying, you know.
You tell me you don't get the chance to do that, you're not gonna do it. You're gonna fucking do it.
Like, come on here guys. If you haven't done it already, like, you know, why haven't you tried? just saying, you know. So guys, we're going to end it here, but I want to actually talk about... Now, this is one that sticks out to me. When was this? It was about a month ago, was it?
Oh, it wasn't that long ago.
Yeah, it was about a month, maybe.
Maybe.
So we're playing this Spelljammer game, and the objective was go to this planet. There was a dead, washed-up Kraken.
And there was
a crime syndicate that was already trying to harvest the Kraken, and we had to...
Clear it.
Like, we had to clear it and procure it for... our crime syndicate. The guy was definitely an undead lich, but he didn't exactly say that, but let's be honest, he was. Anyway, so we fly on over there, and we end up getting ambushed on our way into orbit. We end up, like, boarding the other ship. We get a bit of information, so we do. We decide, you know what, we're going to go in. We manage to get, like, they're all constructs, so they are, and they all kind of look the same, like certain, like, ranked members have the same look. So we decide I would use the hat of disguise to try and go on in. So we've got Jonathan, big shiny robot man, hiding in the bushes. This ends up badly. Who else was it? There was a rogue in the bushes as well.
There was a rogue
well.
In the bushes. There was me and you.
And then there was a clerk.
I'm a fighter. I play a dwarven fighter.
Anyway, so me and Megan go on in. You're wearing the uniform.
The only reason why I played a fighter is because they didn't have a strength build.
Yeah.
And I was like, right, they went, hey, James asked me, Megan, do you want to play? And I was like, yeah, sure, what do you need? And I went, we need heavy bunks.
We need heavy bunks. Pretty much even all the fighters were all dex based. It's ridiculous. Yeah. But anyway, now we actually don't have any wizards. I'm sorry.
We need magic.
We do need magic big time. Anyway, we'll be getting magic soon enough. Fucking Sam's going to be joining. Anyway, on with the story. So we go on in and we walk up to them. I'm with a hat disguise. You're wearing a thingy uniform. Yeah. And I think the clerk was going to come with us, but he ended up just kind of like,
bitching out on us.
It's like, for fuck's sake, any chance, Pedro? Anyway, fuck you, Pedro. Or was it Pedro?
I don't know who it was, but anyway.
Anyway.
So it was only me and James, anyway, who went actually up onto the platform with all the constructs.
And we went on in, we talked to the mean boss man. It's like, oh yeah, no, I'm just here to do, like, you know, run the, do, like, you know,
it's
we
like
audit.
A survey. Like, I'm just here to do an audit, see how things are running,
you know,
how things going. So we kind of got to walk about and survey the place and see, right, what do we have here, what can we do.
So it didn't work out that well. So no. as we say, Jonathan, or
he rolled shit. The sun shined off his shiny tits and everyone was able to see him.
So
and there was a big gorilla.
So
they were tied up fighting this big gorilla man,
and we couldn't do anything. We were kind of stuck there.
What's all that noise?
So
that?
We decided, you know what, we're not, like, I've got a cloak of invisibility, I'm a goblin, Megan's a dwarf, so if we really want to, I could just jump on her shoulders.
Yeah, so we got to one point where we were kind of out of the way of everyone, and they had, like, these vials of, like, ichor that were from the Kraken itself.
It would make you go insane.
There was men on the boats, and I thought to myself, right, what happens if I lift, like, sleight of hand this shit, get some fucking ichor vials and throw it? Are they flammable? Let's fucking try it. Yeah. So I was like, fuck it, we're stuck anyway. Fighting, we're going to get caught out. So I chucked it, and you chucked a match, I think.
Okay, so they start fighting each other. And then,
but it turns them berserk.
Yeah, it makes them. And we start fighting each other. Okay. It's like, oh, bitch! So we managed to do some, like, we managed to go this for a fair amount of time. So what we're doing was, I would go up and, like, pretend to be boss man and sit and talk to them. Be like, oh, mate, come on over here.
And then he would call me, and I would run over and trip.
She would just trip and knock them on the water into the water below with the sharks,
seething with sharks,
and all the boats managed to light on fire. And we did manage to get away with it. We actually did very well. I think we must have.
And there was at the end of it, whenever we were trying to get back to
where
everyone
man?
Else was, there was, like, a captain.
Was it the big shark man?
Yeah, he was, like, controlling the other consorts, and it was a giant shark, and I said, I managed to lift a crate of the ichor vials, and I went, you know what? His mouth's big enough.
Yeah.
So I'm a roll to try and shove this in the shark's mouth. I got, like, kills. An 18 or something. Yeah, I was like, fuck you. Chucked it in its mouth. He ate it. He went berserk. We were managed to get away, but he took down half my health.
Yeah, with one hit, he managed
one
to...
One hit. It was like, running away. It was just...
I think you were level 5, and I think you took near 40 points of damage.
Yeah.
You know?
And we were able to get away, but he went berserk and killed everyone else, and we got out of it. It was great.
Yeah, it was pretty good. We managed to meet up with the rest of the group, like the front. We ended up having to run away in the end, but we did kill most of them there.
And the next time we went back, it was only the shark man.
It was only shark man left. He was just sitting there sad that he killed all his friends. It was one of those ones. It wasn't, I know it's not the best, like, oh mate, you know, it's not the biggest one, but it's one of the ones that sticks out to me, and it's, like, very recent.
Yeah,
you know, and it's one of those ones, oh mate, that was actually a really good session. I really enjoyed it, you know. It was particularly fun being able to, like, oh yeah mate, come on over here, and then you just fucking shove them. I thought it was a lot of fun. fun. Do you have any ones like that, though? You guys
Do you have any Mad Lad stories of your past games?
It doesn't need to be that Mad Lad. Is it just like a game you've had in the past? Like,
that you really
months?
Enjoyed? Like a session that you really enjoyed? Yeah. Like we just told? Like something that sticks out in your head?
Yeah.
Of one that was really fun?
Because it was one of those ones. See, if me and Megan, we weren't doing all that and we just blew great and fight. We were dead.
No,
was,
we were gone.
We would have died within
Especially me being level 5. I was way.
Yeah, I think I was only level 7. Yeah. You know?
It was my first game.
Yeah, it was your first game on the Spelljammer server. It's a lot of fun, though. I'm really enjoying it. And, you know, it's nice. I feel like, you know, it's the first time I've had, like, a constant game since before Kelowna. Like, an actual game where I can have
it's
a guarantee.
It's the first time I've had a constant game for about 2 years now.
Yeah, it was since I went to Texas Speech. Once you took over voiceover. Yeah. Whenever you started doing voiceover, it was pretty much not a chance.
No, not a chance. So, but no, it's the first game I've had in a while. Yeah. And I'm really enjoying it. So it's I'm nice, already thinking you know? Of my next character. So
yeah.
I can't wait.
We'll see what happens. Anyway, tell us about your ones down below. I'm trying to tell us good ones because, as I say, I am kind of sick of horror stories. But we've been babbling on long enough. If you enjoy this and stuff like it, you know, subscribe. It does help us out a lot.
Check out all the links. Check out the models. All that shit. And we'll see you next one. Bye.